Another surprise giver. Our scripture today is from Philippians 3:10-11. I want to know Christ, yes, to know the power of his resurrection and participate in his sufferings, becoming like him in his death. And so, somehow, attaining to the resurrection from the dead. I am a visual learner. I learn by using pictures and asking questions. Do you want to experience how a visual learner learns new things? Follow me. The reason we learn is to understand or know something we don't know. In his letter into Philippians, Paul wants to know Christ and to know the power of his resurrection. Why would a former Pharisee who hated Jesus and his followers make such a statement? As many you know, Paul himself encountered the risen God on the road to Damascus. His life would never be the same. From that moment on, Paul was forever changed. I agree with Paul, the resurrection changes everything. I have experienced it in my life. So how would you describe the resurrection? If you were asked to image a picture of resurrection, what will come up to your mind? Well, this is how I picture it. I am a caterpillar and I shut myself in a cocoon for 7 days. It was dark and crowded inside. But after 7 days, after suffering, I come out from the cocoon and become a butterfly. A new life. Resurrection is a new beginning of creation. Resurrection is a new start of God's actions in the world. It is a beginning of a fresh act of creation. When God created everything, he looks everything is good. Until Adam and Eve fall, sin entered the world through Adam. Death follows sin. All people inherit sin from Adam. The wage of sin is death. Jesus' death and resurrection reconcile us to God. Jesus is the new Adam. He is the true image of God. Jesus is the image of what humanity was also intended to be. Ross and I just watched a movie. I can only imagine. I guess maybe some of you have watched that as well. Maybe. The songwriter Bart Miller grew up in a family which his dad abused him. In the movie, Bart said, "My dad was a monster and I saw God transform him. I did not think God can do that. So I wrote this song for my dad." A reborn Christian is a new creation, a new life, a transformed human. I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you, God said. I will remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. Jesus raised up from death by Father, and it is empowered by the Holy Spirit. Jesus' resurrection was his vindication from those who crucified him. By raising Jesus from the dead, God has overturned the revolt by which Jesus was condemned. God had justified Jesus, and in doing so, declared before the world that he was in fact innocent of all their charges and accusations. His kingdom teachings and actions were true expressions of God's will in the world. By raising Jesus from death, God had honored Jesus, turned the shame of crucifixion into the glory of exalted level in God's presence. By raising Jesus, God liberated him and brought him into the center of God's purpose in the world. In Romans 8:11, if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to you, your mortal bodies, because of his spirit who lives in you. Resurrection is a time to join Jesus' story. For the early followers of Jesus, his resurrection from death was a new beginning and vindication of their teachers, their prophet, and their miracle-working Messiah. When Paul was riding on the road to Damascus, he was on a mission to persecute those who follow Jesus. There at the road, it witnessed the light of resurrected Lord, who said unto him, "Saul, Saul, why do you pursue me?" Imagine what it was like for Paul to tell this church in Philippi that he wanted to participate and share with Jesus' suffering and being like him, comfort him in his death, so attaining to resurrection from death. God was raised Jesus to life, and we are all witness of it. Just as baptism, we were baptized into the death of Jesus. Just as Jesus was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we are too may live a new life. Imagine with me what it will be like without resurrection. Resurrection is a fundamental and central claim of Christian faith. It's the resurrection of Jesus Christ, whom God brought forth from death. The resurrection of death refers to the promise based on the body resurrection of Jesus, that all believers will one day join Christ in the resurrection. Believers will be transformed, renewed, both morally and physically, with spiritual bodies adapted for internal life with God. And if Christ has not been raised, our preaching is useless, and so is your faith. More than that, we are then found to be false witness about God. So we have testified about God that he raised Christ from the dead. But he did not raise him if, in fact, the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised either. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile. You are still in your sins. then those also who have fallen asleep in Christ are lost. If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. That's Corinthians 15, 14 to 19. So I once have a conversation with a pastor. I asked him, "Pastor, do you have any suggestions about how to share gospel?" He said, "Stress on Jesus died for us on the cross, and then we can have eternal life." I asked, "Then how about resurrection?" He told me that I could mention it, but do not expand too much on it, because it will take longer time and it will be hard for people to understand and accept it. For a while, I thought I have an easier way to share gospel. But in truth, it is half of the gospel. How often do we preach only half of the gospel? What does it say about our theology when resurrection is considered nothing more than a footnote to the message of the gospel? The gospel can be also called the good news. Jesus' resurrection is the beginning of God's new project, not to snatch people away from the earth to heaven, but colonize earth with the life of heaven. That, after all, is what the Lord's Prayer is about. That's what N.T. Wright says. If we have a whole life, we can use Bible to tell people about the gospel. If we have several months, we can talk about the full gospels. If we only have several minutes, we can tell them about John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." If we try to use as least as possible to share gospel, what do you think? It is the core of the gospel. My answer are three words: crucifixion and resurrection. Russell's answer is, "He is risen." And then what about yours? As visual learners today together, I would like to provide you another picture about resurrection. JJ and I just talked about it yesterday. We said, "Oh, if tomorrow there will be a sunrise, that will be perfect, right?" So that's like the bulletin, a beautiful sunrise. A sunrise at the dawn. After a long night of suffering, doubting, and wondering, the light overcome the darkness and even death. It is also the reason why we are worshiping here at the West Side today. We want to be witness of resurrection. Billy Graham said, "The resurrection of Christ changed the midnight of bereavement into a sunrise of reunion. It changed the midnight of disappointment into a sunrise of joy. It changed the midnight of fear to a sunrise of peace." for a bonus of you, early birds, today, we are gonna have a Chinese one-on-one class as a bonus. So we all know that he is reason, but do you know how to say it in Chinese?
Yes.
All right, so he is ta, ta, you can feel free to follow me. Ta, is reason, so reason, fu huo, fu huo. Ta fu huo le.
Ta
fu huo le. Let's say it loudly with me together. One more time, okay?
Ta
fu huo le. Let's say it in English together again. He is risen. Yes. This is the reason why we are here today, why we are celebrate and worship together, because he is risen.